I used to go to school with my mother. She was a second grade teacher, and I would watch her teach. And she was very creative. She brought things home that I got to grade. And so from very early on, I saw how she got students involved. And the students loved her. She was mean and very strict. And the students would come up at the end of the day and want to give her a hug. And I couldn't understand this. I asked my mom, you know, what is that about? And she said, students love structure. They want somebody to tell them what's good and what's bad. And even if you tell them what's bad, it's okay. My students really get this mix of, hey, that's really fun, but I really am responsible for learning the materials. I do like to sing. I can't sing very well. But when I sing and I sing a song that has biological lyrics to it, the students are fascinated. So myself and my colleagues sing these in class. We use them as teaching tools. There's a photosynthesis song. There's a song about sodium chloride. There's a song about glucose. And so we like to get up there, we sing the song. I sing in my bad voice, and the students laugh and think it's fun. But they're teaching tools, and it creates some interest in the class. Student projects in my classes have really been anything that you can imagine, from singing a song. They take a regular song, change the words to something biological. They've taken trailers from movies and altered the words into some sort of immunological process that they've learned. So they're really clever in figuring out how they can include course content in products that are teaching tools. They own it. And they love that because they show it to their friends, they put it on YouTube. So it gives a sense of, look what I can do.